What is a module? A module is a functional unit that organizes content. It is similar to a section in a textbook. Whether you are teaching geology, mathematics, American short stories, epistemology, accounting, or any other topic, it is best to chunk that content into digestible pieces to give it structure, consistency, and form. This is particularly true in online delivery to students. Often you can get inspiration from viewing a textbook or a course description or proposal for getting clues on how to best sequence the course content. Ideally, a course should contain 4 to 7 modules to conform to the principles of cognitive load theory. Likewise, a module should cover more than a week of material to ensure that discussion sections have plenty of time for students to develop a post and then foster meaningful discussions. Ideally, 2 or more weeks. Once you've determined the 4 to 7 modules for your course, the module will be most effective if it fits a uniform practice. Each module will cover a particular topic or aspect of study within the overall scope of the course. Ideally, threaded assignments tie the modules together and give cohesion to the course. In general, the structure of the module contains an overview or an at-a-glance section that offers an insight to learning objectives and offers a module roadmap for the student. Content guides offer a section where key content can be accessed. It should do more than refer to the textbook readings. Instead, think of them as offering a space for short lectures on content necessary for meeting the module's objectives, written by a faculty developer or instructor. Links to key readings or source material. Open educational resources with content that prepares students for the learning activities. Learning activities that make the student meet the module's learning objectives. These activities should be engaging and are not necessarily graded. Some activities may include virtual field trips, simulations, group learning activities, or role play exercises. Assessments, while not necessarily for each module, should be constructed to demonstrate that the students can complete the module learning outcomes. These could be non-graded, such as self-tests, or graded exercises that could include written assignments, case studies, pro-con debates, group projects, discussion forums with an open-ended question or set of questions. Online resources that can be from the library or elsewhere that augment the student learning. This section should not be overwhelming, but designed to assist the student without distracting them. This section may be optional and can be deleted if the resources do not assist the students. If you follow these rules and break the course down into a set of 4 to 7 functional units, that is, modules, that have informative titles, the course will be reinforcing an understanding of the course content through the student's passive perception and time spent in the course. Further, by adopting a uniform and proven module format, the students will spend less cognitive time on navigating the course and more time on learning. This will contribute to their success.